Liana Daghbashyan, and you're watching the news broadcast on the state television company Western Armenia. Today's broadcast: earthquake in Kharberd province, Western Armenia. Danger of snowslides in some regions of Western Armenia. There will be no festive events in Stepanakert. Turkish forces move from northwestern Syria to other observation posts in Idlib. The new ambitions of Great Turan in Central Asia. The Artsakh calendar 2021 of the Azerbaijan Armenian Architecture Foundation has been published. The Ministry of Emergency Situations reported that a 5.3 magnitude earthquake shook Kharberd province of Western Armenia. Earthquake cracks were observed in the Caspian Sea. After the earthquake, 49 people went to medical institutions due to fainting and dizziness. There is no information about victims and devastation. A background of low temperature is observed in the southeastern regions of Western Armenia in this period of winter. Due to the abundant precipitation, snowdrifts in a number of places cause inconveniences for traffic and inter-village roads. A danger of snowslides occurs in the mountainous regions, particularly in the mountains of Ven, Hakkari, and Mush. Authorities warn locals and drivers to be careful in the above-mentioned areas to avoid a possible natural disaster. There will be no festive events in Stepanakert. The sky will be illuminated with balloons on December 31 in memory of the heroes. The statement of Stepanakert municipality says, "Dear compatriots, you already know that this year Stepanakert municipality will not organize New Year events. We have huge losses. We can celebrate New Year with special joy. But the day has another concept too. That is to get together, to remember the events of the past year, and to outline what to do next year. Stepanakert municipality invites all of you to the capital's memorial complex in order to incense the memory of our fallen heroes. The sky will be illuminated with balloons, both in Yerevan and Stepanakert, on December 31. Let 2021 be a year of peace and light." As reported by Ter.am, Turkey is withdrawing troops from a military post in the northwest Syria that was surrounded by Syrian government forces. According to the Syrian Observatory for Human Rights, the activists noticed the withdrawal of Turkish military vehicles from their observation post in Al-Tukan district of Idlib. They were sent to Turkish positions in the city of Jabal al-Zaviya in Idlib, where Turkish troops have recently been crowded. On December 18, activists of the center reported that Turkish forces were withdrawing from 12 main observation posts under the control of government forces located in the provinces of Hama, Aleppo, and Idlib. Yesterday, the monitoring center reported a military convoy of 15 vehicles heading to Turkey from Idlib, which crossed the border through the Kafr-Luz observation post. Ankara has started discussions on creating a military political bloc of all Turkish countries, which will be led by Turkey. A military expert, Alexander Mikhailovsky, told the Moskovsky Komsomolets about how the leader of Turkey was trying to carry out the Great Turan. The publication notes that Erdogan announced new military operations that will restore historical justice during a recent parade in Baku. In particular, he hinted at the need to separate the regions populated by ethnic Azeris from Iran. The statements of the leader of Turkey are part of the propaganda of Turkish authorities' program to unite the Turkish-speaking countries in one bloc. Turkish authorities have supported Uyghur separatists in China for a long time by establishing connections with the governments and political parties of the Republic of Central Asia, writes the paper. If earlier one people, two states was used in Ankara, today it is one people, five states. The member of the Young Turk Party actively promoted the Great Turan at the beginning of the 20th century. After that, many of his leaders, in particular Erdogan's idol Enver Pasha, organized the Basmash movement in Central Asia, trying to unite the local peoples based on the linguistic and cultural unity of all Turks. If you look at the plans of the Young Turks, you will get an empire that opposes China, Iran, and Russia. It would be extremely dangerous for these powers to form such an alliance, but Erdogan wants to go that way. The Central Asian governments are ready to receive military aid from Turkey, but they do not want to become the janissaries of our time, says the Russian analyst. Dear compatriots, we would like to inform you that the 2021 edition of the Research on Armenian Architecture Foundation, the Artsakh calendar, has been published. The foundation dedicates the calendar to the subscribers of the RAA Armenia Facebook page, as well as to the members of the Hayastani Patmutyun Girkashari Bajanortner group. Those who wish can come to the office. Now I present you a song, Gutan, by Areg Ensemble.
Oh,
full version of the song is available on the official website of Western Armenia TV. This was all for today. Goodbye.